Hi, I'm Sarah, and today we're going to do the skill of sub-Q injection. So I'm going to log into my computer here. Okay, so we have Morgan Brown, MR number 281345, no known allergies, date of birth, August 4th, 1970. Now I'm going to look for my order. Okay, I see here he has an order from today at 5:22 at 6:30 in the morning for heparin sodium 5,000 units daily to be given sub-Q scheduled for today at 10 a.m. Okay, now I'm going to go to the med cart and get my supplies. I need my medication, heparin. I need a needle. Now when you're doing sub-Q, you need a smaller needle, so this, we want a 5/8 inch, and this is a 25 gauge. You don't need a large needle. Remember, you're going into fatty tissue, so it doesn't go as deep. Gauze pad, some alcohol wipes, and my gloves. I also want to look up the medication. I know that heparin is a blood thinner, and in this case, we're using it for DVT prophylaxis, and we know that Morgan has no known allergies, so that's good. Usually use it for DVT prophylaxis in patients in the hospital that might be bedridden, not getting up as much as they usually do at home, or they might be post-surgery. So here I have heparin. It can be given IV, or we're going to do it sub-Q for DVT, MI, or PE, and the dose is 5,000 units, which is what we're giving today, given every 8 hours. We want to monitor for any signs and symptoms of bleeding, so teach the patient to report any bleeding from their gums, blood in their urine, blood in their stool. Let them know they're going to bruise a little bit easier because of this being a blood thinner. So now I'm going to go over here and I'm going to do my first check. Okay, so I have my medication, heparin sodium, 5,000 units per ml. The medication looks clear, no sediment, nothing floating in it. Expiration date 4/20/39, which is good. I see here heparin sodium, 5,000 units daily to be given sub-Q, ordered today at 6:30, scheduled for 10 a.m. to be given to Morgan Brown. So that's my first check. Now I'm going to do my second check. Again, check the medication, heparin sodium, 5,000 units per ml, be given sub-Q today at 10 a.m. to our patient Morgan Brown. Medication looks good. Expiration date is 4/2039. Now I'm going to go ahead and prepare my medication. I want to rub the top with some alcohol. And needle. Now remember again, you want to draw up air prior to drawing up the medication. So we're going to drop the same amount, a little bit more to leave room for your air to get rid of it. Inject your air, draw up your medication. So we want 1 ml. You can go a little bit more just to make sure you get out that air. Okay, I want to get had a big bubble in there. Okay, Get rid of the air. Then we're gonna do the one-handed scoop. Okay. Now I'm gonna do my third check. Heparin sodium. 5,000 units per ml to be given today, 10 a.m. sub-Q for Morgan Brown. Expiration date for 2039, and I will do my documentation in the room when I administer the medication. Now I am ready to go to the patient's room. Hi, Morgan. It's Sarah, your nurse. How are you doing today?
Good.
I'm here to give you your heparin that the doctor ordered. I'm going to go ahead and give it in your abdomen, in your belly area.
Okay.
Are you experiencing any discomfort or anything at this time?
No, I'm fine.
Okay. And then can you verify your name and date of birth for me?
Sure. It's Morgan Brown, August 4th, 1970.
Okay, great. That's what I see there. All right, so we're giving this medication to you today to prevent you from developing any blood clots while you're here in the hospital. It'll be a really quick injection. Do you have any questions for me?
No, I'm good.
Okay, I'm gonna log in. Just gonna pull up your chart here. Okay, Morgan, I gotta go ahead and scan you here first. Scan your bracelet. Okay, now I'm going to scan the medication. Okay, again, I'm going to document my dose, which is 5,000 units. And then we're going to give it in the patient's abdomen. We'll do right abdomen. Morgan, do you remember where they gave it to the last time?
I think it was on the left side.
Okay, good. Because we never want to give it in the same spot two times in a row. We always want to rotate sites. Okay, I'm going to submit that. Okay, now I just need to clean your belly here. It's going to be a little cold. I'm going to give it in the abdomen, which is the best place to give it. When you're giving heparin, you want to give it at least 2 inches from the umbilicus. You don't want to give it any scars, incisions, stomas. You want to give it right into the skin. I'm going to clean the area. Okay. My injection here. Okay, and you do not aspirate with sub-Q. Go in at a 90-degree angle, little poke. I'm going to give it. Just want to grasp the skin. You don't really have to pinch it too hard. Okay, good. Engage your safety. Apply gauze. Do not rub the site. All right, Morgan. Nice job. We're all done. Get rid of your needle. Cover you back up here. Looks like you still have your call light, your side rails are up, your bed's in the lowest position. Is there anything else I can get for you right now?
I'm fine, thank you.
All right, I'm gonna gather my supplies, log out of the computer. And that completes our skill of sub-Q injection.